The love of Sayyidah Zainab and Umm Kulthum, Bibi Sakina, Fatima al-Sughra, Imam Zain al-Abidin, Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, and all of the captives. One loud sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Sallallahu alayka ya Aba Abdillah. Sallallahu alayka ya Ibn Rasulillah. أعظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصابنا بأبي الأحرار سيد الشهداء أبي عبد الله الحسين. On the night of the 11th of Muharram, the tents of Ahlul Bayt were attacked. This started with the sequence from the moment in which Abi Abdullah al-Husayn's head was severed from his blessed body. Shimr bin Diljoshan, he hacks away at the neck of Abu Abdullah al-Husayn. He takes him by the hair and he raises his blessed head aloft. Sayyida Zainab, all she can see is the feet of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn kicking in pain along the grounds of Karbala. We go to Medina at this very point in time. Umma Salama, she sees in a dream the grandfather of Abi Abdullah al-Husayn, Rasulullah. Rasulullah presents himself in front of Salama. Salama says, Ya Rasulullah, why is it that I see you in this state? Why do I see your hair disheveled? Why do I see you in this state of grief? At this point, Rasulullah says, Salama, I have just come from the plains of Karbala. My son Hussein, his body is lying there in pieces. I have been collecting the blood of all the martyrs, and I still have not finished. I have been digging the grave for my son Hussein, and I still have not finished. Salama says, I woke up at that point. I went into the room in which there was a jar, in which the sand of Karbala was there. This sand had turned into blood. This sand was boiling in blood. At that point, we see that the enemies, they encircle the body of Abu Abdullah. They come and they begin to steal the things from Abu Abdullah's body. One person comes, he steals his turban. Another person comes and takes his slippers. Another comes and begins to take the robes from the lifeless body of Abu Abdullah al-Husayn. At this point, one man comes and crouches by his body and sees that he has a ring upon his finger. He starts to pull the ring, but the ring does not come loose. He pulls again, the ring does not come loose. He takes out a dagger and he puts it to the finger of Abu Abdullah. He begins to slice, he begins to chop off the finger. The finger comes loose. He takes the finger with the ring and runs away. And then another man, he comes and he steals the sword. Another man comes and steals more. At this point, one man comes. He says, I wanted to steal the clothes of Aba Abdullah. I began to take his trousers from him. Aba Abdullah put one hand upon those trousers. I could not pull them away, so I took out my sword. I severed the wrist of Aba Abdullah. And then I went to take the trousers again. But this time Aba Abdullah put his other hand upon his trousers. I took my sword again and I severed the wrist of Aba Abdullah. I say, in this dream, this man says that Fatima al-Zahra came to me. Oh man, what did you do to my son Hussein? May Allah cut all of your hands, cut both of your feet. May He fling you into the fires of hell. And then it doesn't stop there. They continue to tear apart the body of Abu Abdullah. What happens next? Umar ibn Sa'd calls for riders. He says, O army, who will trample upon the body of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein? He calls for riders. 10 riders step forward. We will trample upon the body of Abu Abdullah. They come up on their horses. They begin to gallop. They begin to ride. Abu Abdullah's body is lying there. He doesn't even have a head. He doesn't even have hands anymore. They come towards the body. Zainul Abidin is lying in his bed. Zainab is back there. She says to him, O Zainul Abidin, what is this sound that I can hear? He says, O Zainab, lift the tent so I may see what is taking place. Zainul Abidin says, that is the sound of the horse's hooves approaching the body of my father Hussein. The horse's hooves begin. They gallop and pick up speed. They approach the body of Abu Abdullah. Zainul Abidin says that my father's body was trampled so badly that his bones were turned into dust. It was as if they were kneading some dough. Kneading this dough. The horses race. They approach the body of Abu Abdullah and they trample upon the chest of Abu Abdullah Hussein. His body is torn to pieces underneath the horse's hooves. At this point, Umar ibn Sa'd turns towards his army and he says to them, behead each and every one of the soldiers from the camp of Hussein. And they come and they bring their swords. Each one of the bodies is lined up. They come and strike off the head of Akbar. They strike off the head of Abbas. They strike off the head of Qasim. They strike off the heads of even little old Muhammad. These heads are placed high up on the spear. At this point now, it is narrated that they say, attack the camps of Hussein ibn Ali. At this point, they ride towards the camp. The first one who comes out of the camp is a young daughter of Hussein by the name of Fatima al-Sughra. Oh Fatima, which name do you bear? You bear the name of your grandmother Fatima al-Zahra. What are they about to do to you, oh little child? Fatima al-Sughra is standing outside the tents. She says, I saw riders beginning to approach. They came closer and closer. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know whether I should go back into the tents or whether I should flee. As they came closer, I decided to flee from the tents. I turned and I ran. I ran as fast as I could away from the enemies. But one of the horse riders caught up with me. He ran. He chased me down. He took out his spear. He turned it round towards the backside. And as he caught me, he struck me with the backside of the spear upon my back. I fell towards the floor. When I fell towards the floor, he came upon me and he started to loot me. He ripped the earrings from my ear. He took the cloth that was upon my head. At that point, as he began to strike me, I fell unconscious. When I woke up a little while later, I was resting upon the lap of my auntie Kulthum. I looked at my auntie and said, Oh, Umm Kulthum, what has befallen upon us? Please, is there a cloth that I can cover my head with? Kulthum looked down and said, Oh my dear niece, even your auntie Zainab doesn't, even your auntie Kulthum, she doesn't have a cloth at this moment in time. They continued to attack the tents. They began to ransack the tents. Children were running left and were running right. One narration says that Shimr bin Diljoshan, he entered in towards the tent. What he did was he saw Zainul Abidin lying there in a state of unconscious. One man shouted out, "Do not leave any of these captives alive. Kill them all." Shimr took out a dagger and he took a step forward towards Zainul Abidin. Humayd bin Muslim says, "I called out, 'O man, do you approach a man who is lying sick? He is unconscious. Do you wish to kill a young man who is in the state of being unconscious?'" At this point, Zainab, she comes in front of Shimr and says, "Oh Shimr, you will have to kill me before you kill Zainul Abidin." At this point, another man enters into the tent. Zainul Abidin is still lying in a state of semi-consciousness. He comes and he pulls that rug from underneath which Zainul Abidin is lying upon. Oh, what must have happened upon this day? They continue to chase the young children. They do not stop there. At this point, Fatimah al-Sughra says, "Another man came towards me. As he came towards me, he put his hands upon my leg and he decided to take the ankle ring from me. As he was doing so, he was crying and weeping. I said, 'Oh man, why do you cry whilst you steal from the women of Ahlul Bayt?' He said, 'I fear that if I do not steal from you, someone else will steal from you.'" And then one young child by the name of Sakina, she is running from tent to tent. The enemies of Allah, they bring fire. They bring firewood towards the tents. They come towards the tents and they begin to set the tents alight. The children are running from one tent to another tent to another tent. Sakina's clothes set alight. "Oh Sakina, your body is being burnt by this fire." She runs out in towards the area of the battlefield. She comes across a man. She says, "Oh man, are you from us or are you against us? Are you with us or are you against us?" This man cries out, "I am neither with you nor am I against you." Sakina says to him, "Oh man, if that is the case, can you point me towards the direction of Najaf? For I wish to complain to my grandfather Ali ibn Abi Talib about what has happened to us. I wish to complain to my grandfather Ali ibn Abi Talib." At this point, they continue to ransack. They continue to steal. One man comes towards Sakina. He raises his hand so high and then he slaps her across the face. She falls towards the floor. "Father, where are you to protect your Sakina at this point in time?" They continue to pillage. They continue to steal. The ears of the children are bleeding upon their own cloth. One narration says that as the children were running in the darkness of the night from one camp to another camp, there were thorn bushes that were situated between the camp. When they ran to seek protection and refuge, they could not see in front of themselves. They would fall upon those thorn bushes, not knowing what was in front of them. Sayyida Zainab and Umm Kulthum come out of the tents and they come to find the children. They find one young girl. She is lying still. Zainab and Umm Kulthum come towards this child. They bend down towards this child. "Child, wake up. Child, let us take you back towards the tents. Child, come with us." They do not respond. They do not hear anything from this child. Zainab and Umm Kulthum look at each other. "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un." This child has died from the pangs upon this day. It still does not end there, because at this point, after they have ransacked, after they have tortured, after they have slapped and beaten the children, they eventually come and give water towards the children. The enemies come and they bring a small flask of water. Zainab takes this water. Zainab says, "Oh, Umm Kulthum, you drink." Kulthum Umm takes it towards the children. She passes it to Fatima. Fatima says, I will not drink until Sakina drinks. She passes this flask towards Sakina. Sakina takes this flask and begins to walk. Oh, Sakina, where are you going? I am going to my brother Asghar. He was so thirsty. I want Asghar to drink before I have a sip of this water. And then the night falls, it continues, and eventually Zainab and Umm Kulthum bring all the children together. Zainab, she is sitting outside watching for the darkness, seeing who will come, seeing who might attack at this point. She is sitting down, ensuring all the children are getting a small amount of rest. She sees a rider coming towards them. At that point she stands up and calls out, oh rider, I ask you, we have just managed to get the children to sleep. If you want to plunder us, come back in the morning. If we have anything left, you may take it from us. The man continues to ride. She says again, please, I beg you, do not come towards us. Stop coming. Again, the man continues to ride. And then she says, if you do not stop coming towards us, I swear, I will turn towards Najaf. I will complain to my father Ali ibn Abi Talib about you. The man rides towards her. He disembarks his horse. He opens his arms and says, oh Zainab, my daughter, I am your father Ali ibn Abi Talib. I have been with you since you left Medina. I have seen what they did to your brother. I have been with you all night and I will be here to protect you.
Matim Hussein, Ya Hussein.